Man in the world is trying to build up his life, his career, his family, his talents, many things. Everybody tries to be come up in life. It is God who builds up the life. When we commit our life to Him, that's what we read in the book of Proverbs, chapter 23, verse 18. There is surely a future hope for you, and all your hope will not be cut off. There is a future, there is hope for you in God. And we wish Father the same. And that's what Stephen also teaches us. When we look into the life of Saint Stephen, we find him as a young man. He was not there when Jesus was preaching the word of God to become an apostle or a disciple. Then when the apostles were busy after the resurrection of Jesus, there were few people who were running around the apostles to continue to be in the presence of God. It's like the flies run around the flowers. Though the flowers are having the scent, the sweet smell and the honey, the birds also learn to share that, and they can also take the honey and make into honeycombs if they desire. All of us need not become the apostles and disciples of the Lord, but moving around the Lord. The apostles did not yearn the anointing. The flowers don't yearn the nectar, the honey. It is the Lord who gives to the flower, and it can be shared by anybody who move around that honey. Yes, that's what happened to Stephen. He was not there during the Lord's Jesus time, but when he came to know the Lord, he hungered for the presence of God. He was running around the apostles and enjoying the holy, mighty anointing of the Lord. When the Greek woman complained to the apostles that in the distribution of food, they are not given justice, the apostles gathered. They said, we are here to supposed to preach the word of God. Now we have to how to take care of the problem, the social problem of taking care of this woman, distribution of food and so on. So they found some men who were living a righteous life, who are full of the Holy Spirit. When you run around God, hunger for God, God will find His own way to choose you in His ministry, in His work, and He will honor you. And one among them who are chosen to distribute food as person of righteous living and full of the Holy Spirit was Saint Stephen. So number one, we find Stephen having a hunger for God. This hunger for God, hunger for God's presence, made him to move around the apostles. The hunger for God gave him an appointment to work with apostles, to do the work of God, like a disciple of God. Third, we find as he was doing his duty so faithfully, God raised him up. The Holy Spirit of God raised him up, which some of the apostles were not doing. What is that? During that time in Jerusalem, many were afraid. The apostles, some of them were even afraid. Even Peter went to the house of Simon and sitting there. But Stephen courageously proclaiming the word of God. We find only Stephen that moment proclaiming powerfully the word of God. After Peter's sermon, we don't find much, but Stephen was proclaiming the word of God. Not blaming the apostles, not blaming. The Holy Spirit looks for a person. Whether you are a priest, you are a nun, you are an apostle, doesn't matter. If you have a hunger to proclaim Jesus, the Holy Spirit will use you. Yes. We find him as an ordinary worker, moving around the apostles. Second, he become one of the member of the disciples. Now, the great commission of Jesus is fulfilled by Stephen. He proclaims the word of God. So everyone's eyes are fallen on Stephen. This man is full of wisdom, full of the power of the Holy Spirit. And they caught him. And they brought him into the Sanhedrin. And they began to accuse him. We find Stephen, when he is filled with the anointing of the Lord, he is least to bother about what others think about him, what others are blaming him. He is not following our Moses teaching. He is doing something wrong to the church, to the synagogue, to the temple. He is least to bother about all that. His focus is on the Lord. Yes. Though that lotus is thrown into the dirty pond, it keeps the mud in its place and it comes up. And its leaves have got its own oil, so its flowers shine in the sun. Yes. The same way, though Stephen was thrown with all kinds of accusation, the man of God will not be shaken by the dirt thrown by the world or the problems that surround his or her life. They know 1 Peter 5:7. Place all your worries upon the Lord, for you have a God who cares for you. They know Romans 11:18, which says, 28 says that it is the root that sustains the tree. Be rooted in the Lord and do everything for the Lord. So Stephen is focusing on the Lord. And his face was shining. Yes. We find fourth, when it was given an opportunity, he proclaims Jesus from the Old Testament till the life of Abraham, life of Isaac, Jacob, Moses, prophets, one by one. And then he brings that Jesus is the Messiah. He proclaims to them, gives them the longest sermon ever preached in the Bible. Yes, one man, he kept everyone to keep their hands over their mouth. He proclaimed with wisdom and proved Jesus is the Lord. My dear friends, when crisis come, don't get upset. For the children of God, crisis is an opportunity to proclaim the Lord whom you have. We don't get upset with the crisis and problems. If God allows us, maybe God wants to bring lotus from the dirt. Maybe that dirting place needs a lotus to make the place beautiful. There is nothing else. And the lotus has to be always focused on the sun. As soon as the sun comes, it will shine. Yes. Wait for the Lord. The people who are struggling in the world, they don't allow themselves to be drowned in the problem, but they wait for the sun, wait for the Lord, and when the opportunity comes, they will shine in the Lord. Yes, Stephen made use of the crisis into an opportunity to proclaim Jesus. And everyone looked at him, and the light of heaven was shining on them. So even to those who are accusing him, he gave them the glimpse of heaven, an opportunity to repent. Whether others repent or not, your life and my life gives an opportunity even to our enemies to tell them that God is living. And he gives his light upon ordinary human beings whose lives are rooted in the Lord. If you are rooted in the Lord, you too will shine with the light of the Lord.